Thank you for joining Craig's Gun Channel this week. This week I thought we would talk about the operation of a recoil-operated firearm. What exactly does that mean? Well, when you fire a weapon, that kick that you feel, that's what's called the recoil. And there's quite a bit of energy that's there. And a recoil-operated weapon uses that energy to operate the action. What will happen when you pull the trigger, the hammer or the striker, whatever the firearm uses, will fly forward, detonate the primer, which ignites the cartridge. When the cartridge, the powder in it ignites, it will propel the bullet forward, which is what happens when you fire the gun. That energy that's developed will also start to push the slide and the barrel backwards. Now, with a recoil-operated firearm, the barrel and the slide are locked together at the moment that you pull the trigger and the firearm is fired. In this example, it's a 1911-45, and this particular design utilizes locking lugs on the top of the barrel, which match into recesses in the inside of the slide. The barrel also has a pivot linkage that attaches the barrel to the frame assembly. So when the firearm is fired, the recoil energy will push the slide and the barrel assembly, which is locked together, rearward. Once it travels back a small distance, that pivot linkage will begin to pull the barrel down. Now, once the barrel comes down far enough, it disengages those locking lugs from the notches in the slide, which then unlocks the two pieces from each other. At that point, the slide will continue its rearward motion, which will eject the cartridge. At the end of its travel, the recoil springs will push the slide forward. On the way forward, it will pick up a cartridge out of the magazine and chamber it into the chamber of the barrel and begin to push the barrel forward. As the barrel moves forward, that pivot linkage will push the barrel back up into the slide, and those lugs will engage into the notches again. It will lock them back together. And then the slide will eventually travel all the way forward, and the firearm is ready to be fired again. I hope this information is of use to you. And if you enjoy this type of information, or if you enjoyed this video, please like the video. If you want to continue to see this type of content, please hit subscribe. And as always, be safe, and I'll see you next week.